हेलो। यार से होते ಮಣ್ಣನ್ನ ಲಿಂಕ್ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಯಾ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯು ನೋಟೆಡ್ ಡೌನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್? ಯಾ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಹಿಯರ್? Gautam, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Have you noted down this problem?
Yes, sir. Noting now, sir. One.
Yeah. The spring-loaded safety valve for a boiler is required to blow off at a pressure of 1.3 megapascal. The diameter of the valve is 60 mm. And the maximum lift of the valve is 15 mm. I think we have taken down this problem in the previous class itself.
Yes,
sir. Design a suitable compression spring for the valve, assuming spring index as 6 and providing with the initial compression of 25 mm. Okay, so that is the deflection 25 mm, spring index is 6. So area of the valve we have to find out, because we are given with the valve diameter. Yeah, I think we have taken up this up to this, right? In the previous class itself.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we'll move on to the next one, next part of the problem.
Sure, sir.
Yeah. That is the next part of the problem. So first is you need to find out area of the valve by pi d square by 4 by using diameter of the valve as 60 millimeter. So from there you will get area of the valve. So once you know the area of the valve, multiply it by pressure. That is 1.3 megapascal given in the problem. Okay, it has to blow off at a pressure of 1.3 megapascal. So from there you can calculate the load on the spring. So that amounts to 3675.6 newton. Okay, and for C is equal to 6, K value is going to be 1.2525, and then from shear stress equation, so we know the shear stress given in the problem as 450 megapascal. So D by D, you replace it by one capital C there. So 8F CK by pi D square is going to be the equation, and substitute, you will get the diameter as 12.5 mm. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So moving on to the next part. So you can calculate capital diameter, that is mean coil diameter, that is given by spring index into wire diameter will give you the mean coil diameter. Outside diameter is going to be mean coil diameter plus diameter of the wire will give you outside diameter. Inside diameter will be mean coil diameter minus diameter of the wire will give you the value of inner diameter of the spring. Then from deflection equation, 8F dQ by GD to the power 4. In the problem, it is given that as initial compression is 25 mm. So that is the deflection. So from there, you will get number of coils as 5. Active number of coils as 5. So total number of coils is going to be 7. And then use that into equation of free length. I plus 2 or just a chi dash into D plus 25. Plus 25% of 25, that is 0.25 times 25 will be the value of A. You will get free length, then solid height, pitch of the spring. That's all you need to do in spring design. Is that okay? Note down the problem on similar lines. This was asked for 15 marks. Design. Yeah. Shri Prasad, can you hear me? Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Note down the problem. Design a helical spring for a spring-loaded safety valve. Can you see this problem on the screen? Design,
yes, sir.
Design a helical spring for a spring-loaded safety valve, that is a ram's bottom safety valve, for the following conditions. Diameter of valve seat is 60 mm. That is essentially the diameter of the valve, that is 60 mm. So using this 60 mm diameter of the valve, you can find out area of the valve. Operating pressure is 0.7 newton per mm square, and maximum pressure when the valve blows off freely is 0.75 newton per mm square. Okay. Please note, there are two pressures in the problem. One is the operating pressure. Another is when the valve blows off freely. That is another pressure, 0.75. So what you get is F2 and F1 correspondingly, right? Maximum lift of the valve when the pressure rises from 0.7 to 0.75 newton per mm square is 3.5 mm. What is this value? What is this value?
Y dash.
Yeah, exactly. Correct. So lift of the valve is 3.5 Y dash. Maximum allowable stress is 550 newton per mm square. G is 84 into 10 power 3 newton per mm square. Spring index is 6. Okay. So compared to previous problem, the only variation is there are two pressures. Okay. So you are given with the valve diameter as 60 mm. find the area of the valve by using pi d square by 4. That will give you the area of the valve. Multiply by operating pressure will give you, that is 0.7 pressure will give you the value of load at 0.7 pressure. Multiply the area of the valve by 0.75, that will give you the value of F2. Okay, so the deflection, right, is when valve lift is given, the deflection is given by Y dash F2 by F2 minus F1. Are you there? Yeah, Ishant, can you understand? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, pressure is 0.7, diameter of the valve is 60 mm, so therefore area of the valve is
280.4.
Okay, so from there, P1 into area of valve will give you F1, P2 into area of valve will give you F2, and valve lift is 3.5 mm given in the problem. Tau V is 550 megapascal given in the problem. So for maximum deflection, when valve lift is given by Y is equal to Y dash F2 by F2 minus F1. This is given by equation 11.7b of your data handbook. Okay, so F2 is P2 into area of valve. P2 is nothing but 0.75. F1 is P1 into area of valve. P1 is nothing but 0.7 Newton per mm square. You will get the value of the deflection as 52.5 mm. So for a spring index of 6, K is 1.2525. Okay. And here, while calculating the diameter, while determining the diameter of the wire, why I have taken F2? Can anyone let me know why I have taken F2 here?
So maximum force.
Yeah, maximum load, exactly. Okay, so that will give us the worst case design for a spring. Okay, so if it can withstand F2 load, definitely it can withstand. If it can withstand F2 load, it can definitely withstand F1 load because F2 is maximum. Okay. Then find out the diameter of the wire. So that amounts to around 9 mm. And remaining things, I think you can find out. Not an issue. You can design or find the other parameters of the spring. Please calculate and find these values. Nilesh, are you calculating? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Are you getting the diameter of wire as 8.58? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Rishabh Pandey, working?
Yes, sir.
Yogananda, Martidira?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please check your answers with the answers that are there on your screens. If there's any variation, please let me know. Simika, are you working? Niharika, working? Okay, we'll move on to the next next problem. Okay. Yeah. Not on this problem. Design a helical spring. Design a helical spring for a safety valve. Design a helical spring for a safety valve. The valve must blow off at a pressure of 1.2 megapascal. Blow off at a pressure of 1.2 megapascal and should lift by 3 mm for 5% increase in pressure. Please note down the problem. So the valve must blow off at a pressure of 1.2 megapascal and the lift by 3 mm for 5% increase in pressure. Okay, that is you have blow off pressure as 1.2, lift 3 mm at a 5% increase in pressure. That is 1.2 multiplied by 1.05 will give you 1.26. That is the higher pressure when the valve will lift by 3 mm. The valve diameter is again given as 60 mm. Tau is 400 mega Newton per mm square, G is given. So spring index, you have to take it as 8 over here. So again, you are given with the pressure 1.2, P2 is 1.26 with increase in 5% increase in pressure. Okay, please note this. So 1.2, okay, increase of 5% will give you 1.26 megapascal. So for 1.26 megapascal, valve lift given is 3 mm. So use deflection, again you will get it as 63 millimeter with the y dash equal to 3 mm. Calculate F2 and F1 as we did in our previous example. Okay, P1 AV, P2 AV will give you F1 and F2. Use F2 to find out wire diameter. Okay, use Y2 is equal to y dash F2 by F2 minus F1 for calculating the deflection. Then from deflection equation, find number of coils, then total coils, then pitch of the pitch and free length of the spring. Akhil KV, you are able to hear? Basuraj Autigar, are you there? Basuraj? Yeah. Anishka, are you there? Nirab Nembang. Nobody is.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Are you getting the answer? Please check your answers. Any difficulty? Nihar Venkat Sai. Any problem, Nihar? Okay. Okay, we'll move to the next problem. Sumukh, we are completed the problem.
Sir, writing, sir.
Yeah. Make it fast. Don't blindly copy from the screen. Okay. Please solve the problem. Use calculator. Note down the equations, substitution, and then simplification. Don't blindly copy from the screen. It does not serve the purpose of learning. Okay, we'll move to the next problem. Yeah, note down this problem. The following data refers to, the following data refers to the valve of a petrol engine. The following data refers to the valve of a petrol engine. Length of spring when valve is open is 40 mm. Length of spring when valve is closed is 48 mm. Okay. So between valve opening and closing. The length of spring will vary from 48 and 40. So that will essentially give you the
Y.
Valve lift. No, not Y. It is Y dash. Valve lift. This is valve. We are talking about valve. Okay. Valve open and valve close. So that will give you valve lift Y dash. Next. Spring load when valve is closed is 350 Newton. And spring load when valve is open is 220 Newton. Spring index he has given is 8. The maximum shear stress allowed is 150 MPa. And the modulus of rigidity for spring material is 84 GPa. The ends are squared and ground. And the gap between adjacent coils is 0.1 times the wire diameter. Please underline this. Okay. The gap between adjacent coils is 0.1 times the wire diameter. So that essentially will come while calculating. Okay. The free length. Right. Next. Determine the following wire diameter, mean coil diameter, number of active coils, free length of the spring, pitch of the coils. Okay. So that is valve is open and close. So the valve lift is going to be 8 mm. That is a Y dash. Maximum stress given is, I mean, maximum load given is 350 Newton. Minimum load given is 220 Newton. Yeah, sorry. Spring index is 6.8 and not 8. Spring index is 6.8 because it's not visible because of this bar that's coming on the screen. So the valve index, I mean the spring index is 6.8. Tau given is 150 MPa. So with C is equal to 6.8, we'll get Wall's correction factor as 1.22. With tau is equal to 150, F is a maximum value of F we need to use. So therefore, I have taken F2 here. D by D 6.8. K is 1.22. I'll get the diameter of the wire as 7 mm. So therefore, my mean coil diameter, when I multiply the 7 with 6.8, that is spring index, I'm going to get mean coil diameter. I know the valve lift. I know the two loads F1 and F2. I'm going to get the value of deflection as 21.54. Using the deflection equation, I can calculate the number of active coils. So therefore, total coils is going to be 2 more than that. If you have any doubt, please let me know. It is similar to previous problem, except that we need to get the y dash from this description of the problem. That's all. Please calculate and cross-check your answer. If there is any variation, please let me know. Yeah, only variation is, please all of you listen. All of you listen. Here I have taken 0.25 into 21.54 as the value of A. But that is, don't take that. Here he has given you gap between adjacent coils is 0.1 times the wire diameter. Okay. That is 0.1 times 7. So use that value. That is 0.1 into 7 for so many number of coils. Multiplied by so many number of coils. That is 15 plus 2. 17 number of coils. 17 coils. And each coil has got a gap of 0.1 into 7.
So repeat, sir, once.
Yeah, I'll repeat it again. See, the gap between adjacent coils is 0.1 times the wire diameter is what he has given in the problem. Correct? Correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The value of A is nothing but will give you the gap between the coils. So earlier we used to take it as 25 times the deflection. Correct? 25% of deflection. Correct?
Yes, sir.
That was the total gap A. But here in this problem, he has given you for each coil, it is 0.1 times the wire diameter. That is 0.1 multiplied by 7. That is the wire diameter that we have calculated. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is the gap. What is the value of that? 0.1 into 7 is how much?
0.7.
Okay. So 0.7. Multiplied by how many coils are there now? 17 coils.
17.
So 0.7 into 17 will be the value of A and not this 0.25 into 21.54 what I have taken. Okay, don't take this value. In place of here, use 0.7 into 17 as the value for A. So then you will get a different value of free length. Please let me know this value of free length.
So 152.44.
152.44, exactly. Super. Okay. And the value of pitch?
So 9.22, sir.
9.22. Okay. One second. So free length is 152.4, correct? No?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. The pitch is 9.22 is what you are going to get, correct?
Sir, yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Shall we move on to the next problem? Others, have you noted down? Rohan, noted? Tirumani Shetty, Rohan, are you there? No voice. Okay. Vivian? Vivian, can you hear? Sanjay? Shall we move on to the next problem?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Note down this problem.
So your voice is breaking.
Yeah. Now you can hear properly. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah. Please note down this problem on similar lines. Following particulars refers to a valve spring. Assume static loading. Ends are ground and flat, so you will be adding +2 to the active number of coils. Length of valve when open, 41 mm. Length of valve when it's closed, 49 mm. Spring when is open, spring load at open is 360 Newton. When it is closed is 220 Newton. Maximum inside a diameter of spring is not to exceed 25 mm. So please note this carefully. That is, your DI is 25 mm. Okay, inside diameter of the coil. D is 8.3 into 10 power 4 megapascal and allowable stress is 650 megapascal. Note down this problem. Noted down the problem.
The screen is not visible, sir.
Look, yes, sir. Can you show the screen, sir?
Yeah. Can you see that now?
No, sir. Yes, sir.
This is.
Can you see the screen now? Yeah, can you see the screen?
No, internet.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because this will give you the solution for that problem.
Sir, can you go back to the before page?
Before page, yeah. I think it will go. One second. Yeah, okay. Please note down, the inside diameter of spring is not to exceed 25 mm. This is the condition given. That is, DI value should be 25 mm. Okay. Shall I close this screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. So this is where the problem needs to be solved like this. Deflection is y dash f2 by f2 minus f1. So you can find out the value of the deflection. Then find out torque, that is f into d by 2, where d is di plus d as we know. So di is 25 mm given in the problem plus d, 25 plus d. Substitute this 25 plus d into torque equation. So torsion equation, so this is what after simplification that you are going to get. Then go to shear stress equation. given by 16t by pi d cube. So you will get it in terms of cubic equation. Solving this cubic equation, you are going to get standard value of 3.6. So please work out. Please work out on this. Tau value is given. So T is 4500 plus 180 D. So that is equal to pi d cube into tau value is given divided by 16. You will get it as 127.6 D cube. Simplify this. You will get 3.6. Please let me 3.42. Standard wire diameter is 3.6. Gautam, can you solve this problem and let me know whether 3.42 is correct?
Yes, 1 minute.
Yeah.
Yes, sir, we'll get 3.42.
Oh, excellent. 3.42. Okay. So that is the standard wire diameter from table is 3.6. Okay. So now we will get mean coil diameter as 28.6.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, excellent. Good. Okay. Nice. So so D by D spring index will
get 3.42, sir.
Yeah, 3.42. So for that, standard wire diameter from table is going to be 3.6. So use 3.6 as wire diameter and then get spring index and in turn get the walls correction factor. Go to deflection equation straight away and then get the number of active coils as 7 and total number of coils is going to be 7 plus 2, that's going to be 9. And again, since no condition is given, we here we take A value as 25% of the total deflection. Check whether you get the values properly. Check your answers, please, with the remaining. Don't consider this tau is equal to 8 FDK by pi d cube. Maybe if you consider that, you will get again the diameter as 3.6 only, because from there only we derived other parameters. Okay, shall we move on to the next one?
So could you wait for 1 minute, sir?
Yeah. Okay, we'll take up this problem. This was asked for 8 marks. Another bit interesting problem. A railway wagon weighing, can you all hear me?
Yes, sir.
A railway wagon weighing 40 kilonewton and moving with a speed of 10 kilometers per hour has to be stopped by 4 buffer springs, in which the maximum deflection obtained is 200 mm. Find the number of turns in each spring.
It says maximum compression, sir. So compression, deflection, same thing, sir.
Yeah. Maximum compression allowed is 200 mm, in which the maximum compression allowed is 200 mm. Find the number of turns in each of the spring, in each spring of mean diameter 150 mm. So you are given with the mean diameter as 150 mm and where diameter of the spring wire is 25 mm given. So 150 by 25 will give you spring index as 6. Take G is equal to 82.7 into 10 power 3 megapascal. Yeah. Before we get into the solution of this problem, please note down anyway. Have you noted down, all of you?
One second, sir.
Yeah. Just note down the problem. Don't note down the answer. I'll give you a small explanation, then you can solve it on your own. Not an issue.